2016 is going to have some amazing things coming. I'm hoping this year will be a new year, a new start. I will be able to get back on the vlog train and get more videos posted up. We have a big surprise up our sleeve, you know, something that Hector and I have talked about for a while with the kids and stuff, and we're going to have an announcement coming soon, maybe in like a month or two. Alex is doing really, really good today. He's got a big day. He has some therapy where he will be getting his new walker, so I'm going to take you along to show you that. It's going to be amazing. And that is Zoe. She is whining. She is whining. Dogs. We've missed you guys. We're back. Stay tuned. Subscribe if you haven't. It means a lot to us. Like our videos if you like us. And comment below if you have any questions. And we also have that Bean Boozled challenge we need to get out to you for reaching 200 subscribers. And the last couple of months, like I said, have just been busy and hectic. And then Hector and I have been sick. The kids have been sick. Just a lot of things going on. So we are going to get that out to you soon as well. Subscribe, share our family, get us out there. Because not just for us, but we like to bring awareness of Alex's disabilities and answer questions that people have, see kind of what it is in our shoes to go through this life that God has thrown at us. And I don't know, just show you that just because you have a disability doesn't mean you can't do anything. Alex is one amazing little boy. He has actually been nominated for this Mr. Ike pageant. And for those of you that are from Yakima and went to Ike or Davis, you kind of know the gist of everything. But the Mr. Ike pageant is a group of juniors and senior guys. They go and they raise money for Children's Miracle Network, which in this case is money for our local Children's Village, which Alex has been attending since he was about 1.5. And that's like a therapy service. And they have people that come from Children's Hospital. We do therapies. We do doctor's appointments. We do a whole bunch of things like that. And they raise money for Children's Village to keep it going, because Children's Village is basically run off of donations. And it's an amazing place, you know. And so I'm speaking at that. Alex is the star child for this. And so I'm going to take you guys along Alex's journey of being the Mr. Ike star child. I'm so excited. So stay tuned for all that too. It's going to be an amazing year. I'm telling you, this year is just going to be really, really cool. Holy fog. Look at this stuff. This is like, you barely can see the lights that I'm coming up on, and they're literally right in front of me. It's insane. You can't even see the airport. These are storage units. You can barely see those over there. Ugh. Wow, look at you. I think you'll be okay. Come on in the hallway. The mom can take it really nice.
Mom, take it.
What? Your wheelchair?
Yeah.
Why?
We don't need your wheelchair.
You're not using your wheelchair. You're walking. Look at you, buddy boy.
Okay, where do you want to walk? How about walking this way? Oh, do you want to see the snow?
Sure. That's a good idea.
I don't know. I've never had him walk on linoleum with those braces.
I mean, they're not good, but they're not like all the way to the toes, you know? So
yeah.
This is your desk.
Saturday, and we are going to try out Alex's new walker. We're finally going to take him out and about. He got his brace in finally. And so we're going to take him to Costco since we got to get errands, but we need to be back for football today. So we're trying to kill two birds with one stone. Walk to Costco and get groceries. Yes, Mason. You guys are going to have a lunch at Costco, huh? What?
No, I don't like the tug on
this. What?
I went potty.
Oh, you did, huh? You told us. And so you earned a special lunch today at Costco. See, you can do it.
Hey, Mommy.
What?
We got out the pizza coupon.
No, because we're not going to Pizza Hut. Because we're not. But we're going to go to Costco and we're going to go walk and get some exercise for him. And try not to spend a lot of money at Costco because we tend to kind of go overboard.
She tends to.
No.
Daddy.
Sometimes, maybe. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. Do you like splashing in the puddles?
Daddy, I know it's about.
Are you recording?
I am.
I like it, buddy.
Hold on, yep. Right, Daddy? Mm-hmm.
Look at how straight he is.
Daddy, Daddy eats corn outside. Why do I ever eat corn outside?
Okay, come on.
You need to show the
We gotta go. Yep, let's go inside. We can't step in the middle.
Oh, yeah.
Can I just put him in there?
Okay, can you sit here?
I can turn him off?
Yep, you can turn. Mason, put your feet in the right way. No! Right there.
Can you feel my hand?
Is your hand cold?
No, can you feel?
This one?
It's a little sweaty.
It's a little sweaty. Okay, go.
All right, dude, let's go.
Got it. Ready?
What'd you find now?
Good idea to come.
Oh, a chocolate cake?
My God.
That might be really good.
Chocolate cake filled with icing, rich fudge icing, and chocolate shavings. That's delicious.
Do you want it?
No.
It's expensive though. Oh my gosh.
Here.
You don't want it no more? Is it too hot? The one rule of going to Costco is not to go when you're hungry, huh?
Daddy, is it true?
Nope.
No, yes.
You like to go to Costco when you're hungry? I don't. We spend too much.
No, we don't.
Yeah, we do.
It's $300.
Oh my gosh, I hope not. That's way too much.
Just stop.
That's a lot there. What did you pick to eat?
Pizza.
Is it delicious? Yeah. Mason, what did you pick to eat?
Hot dog.
Is it good?
Mom.
What are you watching?
The Junior. Mom, look.
I know.
We got the cinnamon stick.
I know.
For our dessert.
And then I got a chicken bake and ice cream. And then Hector got a hot dog and he's mad because I got the ice cream. That was a very expensive trip. $150 later. But we should have enough food to last us for a long time. I got good night cheese. And then we had our lunch, obviously. And that was delicious. But now, finally gonna go home. It's crazy how exhausting this one little trip can be, but Alex walked pretty much the whole entire place. So that was really good. He's got to get his legs back used to it, and hopefully in no time he'll be able to walk much, much longer. Well, today is Tuesday the 19th of January, and I've been having a lot of like pain and cramping, and I've decided that I needed to go in to my OB and talk to her and see what was going on, because I was planning on getting my IUD removed. And I go in there to get my IUD removed, and it is lodged up into my uterus. One of the most painful things I've had to go through. It was almost on top of there. It might have even surpassed labor. Yeah, it might have just surpassed that. And she went in trying to pull it out. She couldn't get to it. We had to do an ultrasound to see if it was there, if she could get to it and reach it. Did the ultrasound, she still couldn't reach it. It's lodged way up in there. So the pain was so excruciating and so bad, I cursed at her. I did. I said, "F**k," I don't know how many times. And then she told me, she's like, "Well, I'm not going to put you through this anymore." Because I was at the point of, I told her, I was like, "I'm going to throw up. I'm going to throw up. Like, it hurts so bad. And I'm pass out." And she goes, "Okay," she's like, "I'm going to try one more time." She's like, "And if I don't get it, we're going to have to schedule you for surgery to get it removed." So tried again, failed. So she says that now I have to have surgery on it. She says that this week she slammed with appointments and whatnot. So I'm looking at next week to get my IUD removed. And she said that it's a pretty easy procedure. She says that what happened to me happens maybe once a year in her practice. So what she said is that they're going to put you to sleep. They're going to go up with a camera to look, see exactly where it is, and then go in there, reach it, and pull it out. And she's like, "The good thing is you'll be asleep. You won't feel anything. It'll be fine." And so I asked her, I was like, "Is it going to cause any like long-term damage?" She goes, "No." She's like, "It's just in your uterus." She's like, "You're fine." So that's reassuring. But yeah, so this is what I get to look forward to. I am in a lot of pain right now, and it's no fun. No fun at all. But it's a good thing I went in for the pain, because I've been having a lot of pain and then like this horrible amounts of bleeding. I know, TMI. But yeah, hopefully this works and it comes out easily. And this is just like scary and terrifying, and I don't want this to happen. And but it hurts so bad. It hurt so bad.
What are you doing? My best friend? Are you my best friend? Oh, is that my best friend? Ow, don't claw me. Oh, your best friend. No, no paws. That hurts me. You may paw other people, but it hurts me. Are you my best friend? Why, Alex is away? And then when Alex comes, I don't exist. She got me good with her little claw. But she's my best friend, huh? She just likes to lay right there on me.
What's happening?
Makes her so comfortable.
What's happening, Mom?
So I don't know how well you guys can hear me, but Alex is here to be introduced to Ike for his Mr. Ike thing. And so he's doing fairly well. He hasn't freaked out yet, which is pretty good. He's over there showing the guys what he is doing on his iPad. But I'll try to get what I can. I'm not sure if I'll be able to get a lot. There's a lot of people everywhere. And all the guys are behind us. But we'll see how well this goes.
Special teams coach, Abby Palomares. Wide receiver coach, Brandy Eddy. And dance coach, Michaela Partlow. Being escorted by our 2016 Mr. Ike guys is our miracle child, Alex, and his mom.
Two quads.
It's pretty awesome.
Did so well today, didn't you, Alex? You didn't cry or nothing. You are a big, brave boy. Yeah. So as a reward for him being so good, we came to McDonald's because I promised him an ice cream. And what the heck? It's January and it is 48 degrees out. I got into the car and I was like, what the heck? Why is it so hot? That's why. But I got some footage. I had like somebody in the student body record so we could do it. But yeah, so I'm super excited. I hope it all turns out good. But yeah, let's get some ice cream. We got our ice cream cones, don't we? Is it good? Where is it? Is it delicious? Look at your face.
Yeah.
Your face is a mess.
Yeah.
The mommy's got hers too.
Question right next to his. Then he'll have to admit that mine has more things.
It's crazy after a bath, huh?
He's crazy. I know. What are you doing?
Well, I am heading to Children's Village. I have to speak there this morning at a parent panel at 8 a.m. and it's 7:37 and it's just on the other side of town, I think. Well, it takes me about 5-10 minutes to get there. So I'm on my way there. I have both kids with me because I thought it was tomorrow and so Hector had arranged to take tomorrow off or just come home and take so you could take them to school. So instead I'm taking them both with me and Mason will probably miss preschool today, which is no big deal, but Alex will be late, which is no big deal because I'll only be probably half an hour late maybe at the most. So yeah, but I'm gonna go. We're gonna speak to a group of people and kind of talk about our child, how Children's Village has helped us, and how some of the parent support groups have helped too.
Mom.
But I'm pretty excited to go. I do not do good talking in front of people. This is the third time I'm gonna have to talk in front of a group of people, but I'm doing this. Mom. It's doing pretty good. I'm not doing half as bad as I figured I would. Mom. And after a while, you repeat the same thing over and over. It gets to be like normal and common to you. You know, especially speaking about your child and what you've gone through, the trials and triumphs and the things that have helped, things that haven't helped and all that. So, yeah, but I'm so tired. I'm hurting. It's just, it's Wednesday. It's not Friday yet. It needs to be Friday already. Where are we going?
To basketball.
Who's going to play basketball?
Me and Alex.
Are you going to have fun, Alex?
No.
No?
You're
not gonna go play basketball, so I'm gonna leave you in the car?
Tell me.
We are gonna go and take Alex to his first basketball practice. It's through Children's Village. So I don't know if I'll be able to record too much being there's gonna be other kids there. But I'll try to get what I can, and this is like huge. This is so exciting. I really hope he does well. Are you excited? Just a little bit? You were excited this morning before I turned the phone on.
I'm excited. I'm excited.
Canceling now.
since Alex is part of this, Anyway, since Alex is part of this thing called Mr. Ike, maybe she has to go to the bathroom so she jumps over us. Since Alex is part of this Mr. Ike thing, this group of guys raise money for Children's Village and stuff. The theme was Seahawks. And so if you saw in the video of the assembly, they handed Alex something and they handed me something. And what they handed us were these jerseys. The Mr. Ike 2015-2016 little jerseys for his thing. And so now, whenever we go to one of those functions, we wear the jerseys so they know who Alex is. And yeah, so we just tried them on. We got them like a week ago, but we just put them on. Do you like them? Mm-hmm. You don't like your shirt?
Okay, so what are we gonna make? Are we gonna bake today?
No, I wasn't even talking about baking. Talking about your shirt. Do you like your shirt?
Yeah.
Yeah? And since Alex no longer needs that other walker, Mason wants to use a walker just like Alex. Mom. So they're going around the house in their walkers and being cool.
Don't start it again.
Hector doesn't want to be his normal self in front of the camera. He shies away.
Give me your phone, I'll give you eyesight. Okay.
Give you his phone so you can give him a high five.
Yeah.
Doesn't work that way. And then he kills it with that kind of stuff.
Mason, you gonna dance? Yeah. All right, dance. Ready?
Are you gonna dance too, Alex?
No!
Did I do the robot? So I have no idea how well you can see us, but we are headed to another part of Alex's Mr. Ike thing. We are going to the West Valley Middle School, I believe it is, for a volleyball tournament against the Mr. Ike and Mr. West Valley guys. And so Alex is invited to go to participate and be a part of it. And I'm sick. I don't feel that great, but it's a great thing. I'm feeling a lot better than I figured I'd feel. And so we're gonna go. We're gonna make the best of it. We're gonna have a good time. Alex is gonna love it, huh, buddy? I don't know if you can see him.
Mom.
What?
If you're sick, so that's why my dad can take me.
My daddy's gotta work in the morning, so he's staying home.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. It sucks. It sucks.
Okay, Alex, game plan, alright? We're gonna put you in there, we're gonna set you up, we're gonna explain that D-hole. Woo!
Hey, J-Lo can do it, so can I.
You got it.
join us and watch them? Do you want to sit back down? Yeah? Okay, come over here. We're trying to overcome his fear of falling and walking on his own, and so he's using his brother as his catch support. So get your balance before you step, Alex. Get your balance. You didn't try it. You did better last time. And just keep walking. Don't stop and make yourself fall, Alex. Just walk.
Watch me.
Focus. Focus. Don't just fall. Just walk. Alex, you're doing...